It's dogfight time, but instead of Android versus Android, this time around, it's BlackBerry versus Android. How's it going, guys? I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com, and you guessed it, I got the BlackBerry Z10 up against the Google Nexus 4. This is as purely Google as you can get. This is obviously as purely BlackBerry as you can get. It's stock. It's pretty much awesome on both counts, at least the fanboys think so. And it's going head-to-head in a dogfight comparison. Which one's the best in terms of performance specs, features, and all-around usability? It's part one of a dogfight battle, and it starts right now. You got two devices here that are very different in a lot of ways, but you know what? They're all email internet machines, aren't they? I mean, kind of, when you look at it. The Verizon BlackBerry Z10 finally in the house. It's the white version, too, and it's available at Verizon right now for $199. So 2-year agreement gets you a device for $199. That's going to be right up there with the HTC One when it launches, right up there with the Galaxy S4 when it launches, and a couple of other hot high-end devices. So yes, BlackBerry 10's back. Yes, I'm very excited about the Z10. One of the questions I'm going to ask in this video is, can the Z10 command a $200 price point when the One and the Galaxy S4 and all these other established brands and established OSs are carrying the exact same price point? We'll find out in the video. Then here's the Nexus 4, and unlocked starts at $299 for the 8GB version. 16GB is going to set you back $349, both of those versions through Google Play and through Google's website and through T-Mobile in select instances. Now, specs-wise, you got some nice specs on both of these devices. You got a 1.5 gigahertz dual-core Snapdragon S4 CPU over here. You got a 4.2-inch HD display, so a little bit smaller than what we're seeing on the Android devices. This is just a bit larger than the iPhone 5. 4.2 inches, a nice sweet spot for a lot of people that think 4.7, I mean, my tweet stream blows up on a regular basis with, hey, I hate 5 inches, it's too big. Hey, I hate 4.7 inches, it's too big. Well, for you, this is going to be a great device, at least just from a screen real estate perspective. 4.2 inches, 8 megapixel camera on the back, 1080p HD recording, 1,800 milliamp hour battery in the back. It is removable, and on the Verizon version, you see the big Verizon 4G LTE logo back there, and right up here as well. So you've got that 4G LTE connectivity on Verizon Wireless, 2 gigabytes of RAM, 4.78 ounces, and then over here, the Nexus 4. Now, specs-wise, a bit beefier on the spec side. It's got a 1.5 gigahertz quad-core Snapdragon S4 Pro CPU over here, 2 gigabytes of RAM, 8 or 16 gigabyte configuration, like I said, 8 megapixel camera on the back with 1080p HD recording, and then a 2,100 milliamp hour battery, though it is non-removable. We'll talk more about battery most likely in part 2. It weighs in at 4.9 total ounces. So a little bit heftier on the size front, 4.7 inch HD display with same resolution, or same pixels, I should say, as the Z10. So hey, bigger display, exact same pixels, smaller display here, exact same pixels. So obviously the color density is going to be a little bit better over here on the BlackBerry Z10. So overall, from an image perspective, I would give a slight display edge to the Z10. But let's dive right into the dogfight. Before we go too far, special thanks to our partners at Best Buy Mobile for giving us devices like the Z10 and like the Nexus 4 for use in our One Paw Bandit giveaway, which is our free giveaway game on the site. When you walk into Best Buy Mobile, you'll walk out working. They'll get your email, your contacts, your web, BBM, all that stuff set up. So when you walk out the door, be it with BBM, be it with, you know, Nexus 4, Android 4.2, whatever version of Android, whatever device you get, you will walk out working and be ready to go. So here are the devices, you know, very different, like I said, in a lot of different ways. And this one kind of preserves that industrial look and feel of BlackBerry. You've got your volume rocker on the side, along with a voice command key, whereas over here all you have is a power button. And over on the left-hand side of each one of these devices, volume rocker over here, micro USB charging port, HDMI port over here, and then 3.5 millimeter headphone jack up top on both with the power button up top on the BlackBerry Z10. So you've got that front-facing camera on both of these devices, camera in the rear, as you would expect on both of these devices, and there they are right back up here in the front. So a little bit different, you know, from an overall look and feel perspective. This is very much a glass and kind of, not metal, but glass and just premium materials look and feel here. Now the downside is, you drop this thing, it's probably going to break. And you drop it hard enough, it's most likely going to break because of the glass in the back. Because at least this version is the flat version without the little nubs at the bottom. So when you drop it, it is straight onto the floor or straight onto the surface. You drop it on glass in the front here. Obviously glass in the front here in front of the display, but a little bit more durable in terms of construction and overall feel over here. I feel like I could drop this device and it wouldn't break as easily as the Nexus 4. But again, just a hypothetical thing over here. Now, Android 4.2.2 over here, Jelly Bean, the latest version. It's a stock version as well, so no manufacturer installed user interfaces. Over here, BlackBerry 10 as well. So you got BlackBerry 10 over here. Fantastic look and feel. Can't beat your BlackBerry 10 OS on this device. So you know what? The Q10 is going to have it. The Z10 already has it. And it's a dramatic difference all around for BlackBerry. So you've got, of course, BBM over here. And the big key point, I should say, is a BlackBerry hub. So as you can see, it brings in hub, notifications, BBM, text messages, Gmail, all your kind of social media stuff and text messages and Gmail and hub and all that stuff. Brings it right over here onto the left-hand side. So for example, I can see Gmail if I want to. I can scroll through and see everything in the hub, so I can see all these BBMs. I actually put the BBM pin on a video a couple of days ago, so you see all these BBM people that have messaged me back and forth, and I wish I had more time to respond to everybody. But you got the BlackBerry hub here. You can obviously access Twitter, Facebook, and Gmail through there, through the search, or I should say through the kind of file architecture system, whereas over here, BBM, text messages, Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, and then calls all in one place. And of course, like I said, you can itemize based on what you want to see. So BlackBerry Hub's really nice, and of course I can swipe right back. And here it's kind of like a cards-based thing, kind of a playbook, or I should say kind of a play from the webOS playbook with your cards over here, and then you've got just swiping to get your applications and more. There's no back button, so compare it to something like Android 4.2.2 with on-screen back, home, and recent application buttons. Now granted, this does have a quad-core processor, so at least for me in day-to-day use, I do find this to be a little bit faster all around. I have had this one hang up a little bit. Actually, I should say I've had both of them hang up, but I see more issues with the BlackBerry Z10 and overall speed. That said, much better than anything BlackBerry's ever produced, but still every now and again, I see a slowdown, but you can expect that, frankly, on any device. You got your cards here. When you want to get rid of them, you know, I want to close New York Times, I can do so, but I can just keep applications open, as you see here, and swipe right up when I'm done, for example, and go ahead and cancel. Let's go out. Newsstand. Got the crazy, all these kids that want a BBM. So you know what? We're going to roll through it in the video. So you can see here, agree, and we can roll right through and get your maps, for example. And I can have all my applications running in the background, so you can see right there. So Wall Street Journal opening up if I want to. And then out of the box over here, you do get some Verizon pre-installed applications. They can be removed. My Verizon Mobile, Backup Plus, Box, Connect to Dropbox, Print to Go, Smart Tags, a bunch of different BlackBerry stuff as well. And we'll talk more about kind of the revamped maps and all the stuff that BlackBerry 10 brings to the table. Now, over here, stock version of Android, and it's not a carrier-based device, so no carrier-installed applications. What you do get is all the different Google applications. Chrome out of the box, Currents out of the box, and then you get some other stuff. Google Plus integration, of course, Google Play Store integration, then you get Twitter, of course, which I've downloaded, and then more. So you get your apps and widgets right here. And 4.2.2, take a look at the Nexus 4 full review if you want to see what it does, but it brings a bunch of new stuff to the table, including this little feature I'm particularly fond of where I can swipe back and forth and easily access stuff without actually unlocking the device. So I want to see a preview of my text messages. I can look right here. I'm not actually unlocking it. I'm just getting all this stuff from the menu itself. I find this widget to be particularly useful as well. It shows me the weather, shows me that it's going to rain and thunder, and it's 46 degrees. My emails, and then of course quick access to the camera as well from there. So all of that without having to unlock the device itself. Now the unlock screen over here on BlackBerry 10 looks like this. You can see I have 13 BlackBerry messages, 1 Facebook message, 4 notifications, 23 Twitter messages, 48 emails on this particular device. So again, a little bit of a difference, and I do like the fact that I can actually do this stuff without unlocking the device. So I can, for example, go into messaging and click directly into messaging if I want to, and go to my text message thread, which I was doing earlier between these two devices. So we'll scroll right back over here, for example, and let's say compose, and I can compose between all my different stuff here, Facebook if I want to, Gmail, text messages. But then if I want to go into specific stuff, I can go to text messages, and I can say, there's my text message thread, and I can go right into it. So just to give you a preview of what both of these look like, here's the BlackBerry Z10 keyboard. Here's the Nexus 4 keyboard. Obviously more screen real estate over on the Nexus 4, but like I said earlier in the video, the colors look great over here on the Z10. Really a clean look, and of course portrait to landscape transitions, nice and easy, and definitely the best BlackBerry keyboard I've seen all around. So I can say the quick brown fox is happy that it is, and you can see the autocorrect. And also you're seeing words pop up, and you're probably thinking to yourself, what is this? Well, you know what? I can continue to go through and have it auto-predict night, too, and I just swipe up and it auto adds that word. So happy Wednesday night to be delivered. Over here, portrait and landscape, nice and quick. Again, stock version of Android, and this is the Android 4.2 keyboard, which does have a swipe light mechanism built in that I can use hunting and pecking if I want to. Quick brown fox is happy that it is Wednesday. Jerry there, the quick brown fox is happy that it's Wednesday. But again, swipe light functionality if you want to use that, and of course you can turn that off if you see fit. Stay tuned for part two. We'll talk about web browsing, speed tests, and more. It's a BlackBerry 10 versus Android, Z10 versus Nexus 4 dogfight battle, and it will continue after the break in part two.